Hi guys, welcome to ELI, the place where you get your daily dose of inspiration for entrepreneurship. And today we have with us Mr. Aditya Sonkar, who is the founder and CEO of RevMeUp, a social review platform to discover, compare, buy and research products. Aditya has attended IIT Bombay for bachelor's in technology in chemistry. Aditya had worked for 4 years in companies like Zenov and Shadow Fox before starting his own venture. So, hi Aditya, welcome to Entrepreneur Launch of India.
Hi Priya, thank you for having me here.
Aditya, why don't you introduce yourself?
Okay, so Priya, basically myself Aditya Sonkar. Yeah, I hail from Kanpur, And so basically I did my schooling here in Methodist, like many of people don't know about it probably, but after that I went to IIT Bombay, did my BTech plus MTech in chemical engineering over there. During that period of time, I explored a lot of things, and chemical engineering as a subject was not that interesting to me, and hence I explored a lot of things, be it extracurricular activities to startups and NGOs and working with in fests. And working in drum, dance, singing, everything else. Okay, so college was a really great place for me to explore and have a new perspective in life. Mm-hmm. And post college, basically, I started my first job at Zenov. It's a management consulting firm, which I as a consultant basically, and it continued for like 3 years. And over there also, I learned about a lot about a professional environment and. How the industry flows and what are the business, how does the businesses flow, what people value, those kind of things. And after that 3 years of stint at Zenov, I joined Shadowfax, which is a logistics company, as a in sales and BD. I was handling sales for different clients over there. So in February, basically, I left my stint at Shadowfax and joined, basically started full time at RevMeUp. RevMeUp was going along since these two companies as well. It was in my mind, and slowly and gradually I was working towards it. But yeah, so in February I started full time on this thing, and since then it has been a great journey for me, and we have grown a lot personally as well as a company, as a team as well. Yeah, so that's pretty much about me.
Mm-hmm. I was going through the LinkedIn page of RevMeUp. I think it's a big team you are handling, a very big team. And in a short time, you have grown
a
huge team. So our audience would be very curious to know, why don't you tell us a bit about RevMeUp? What is RevMeUp? What does it do?
Okay. So RevMeUp is essentially short for RevMeUp. Okay, so it's a social review platform where we are aiming to help users make satisfying buying decisions. Okay, in the current scenario, the problem lies that, for example, we as buyers have a lot of options available right now in the market to buy from. Okay, if you, for example, if I want to buy an earphone in 2000 range, there are like 20 different models. And I don't know which to choose from, what to trust. And the reviews available in the platform, those are the in the platforms like Amazon, Flipkart, Google, and those kind of platforms are not that satisfactory, to watch at or to make my decision. Even though they drive our decisions as per now, but those are not that trustworthy, which I feel personally, and the research which we conducted also, the survey which we conducted also, many people feel the same way. Okay. And hence we thought of having a social review platform, since many a times people go to their friends and family and colleagues to know about a product or get views that for a particular product, if a particular person has used it, that person will be able to tell you the experience of that product, right? Mm-hmm. Moreover, these platforms give you just one time review and not the reviews over the period of time. Okay, just to give you an analogy, if you watch a movie trailer, after watching a trailer, you cannot give a review of a movie, right? When you watch the whole movie, then only you will be able to give a good review about it, right? Mm-hmm. Similarly with products, I cannot give you a good review for after using it for 1-2 months. Okay, I need to, you know, I when the real problem starts after 6 months period of time, 4 months period of time, and nobody's tracking that kind of a relationship with the user of a product. Okay, so one of the aim which we are also targeting is that we are trying to cultivate a relationship between user and a product, so that user is engaged with the product and also gets to know how to use a product in an efficient manner as well, and we'll be connecting and tracking their experience, user's experience with the product, how it has behaved over the period of time. And we basically are, you know, getting into the whole buyer journey experience from the trigger till the end of life of that product. So user will be engaged from the start till the end of our life of that product in our platform. So that is our aim as of now. And so let's see where we'll go. We are getting a good response from the people on the idea and the application as well. 15th of August, we are launching our, first version as NT for the public. Let's see. We are very, you know, finger crossed, and we are very excited for that.
Mm-hmm. So when this all started, when you started building RevMeUp and got into this path of entrepreneurship?
Okay, so basically the path of entrepreneurship actually started like sort of 2 years ago. But the thought of entrepreneurship or the introduction to entrepreneurship started in the college itself. So I worked with my seniors in 2-3 startups actually during my college time, and learned a lot of things that what happens in a startup and how difficult it is to manage funds, how difficult it is to survive, and all these kind of things, how easily a startup can be shut down in, like, you never know. Like you have planned a runway for 6 months, in next 1 month you are dead. Like, so all these things I've seen very closely with my seniors. And I had this idea this is entrepreneurship, it is difficult, but I also already have this thing I have to do one day. I don't know when, but I have to do one day. And then 2 years ago, I had this idea, I was just discussing with my friend about this thing. There's a friend of mine with whom I discuss a lot of gadgets, reviews, technology, so I understood one day we were discussing a lot of things about a product, and there's no actual real platform where we can, see reviews and make our decision. So that kind of a thing hit me people do read a lot of reviews in blogs, in terms of YouTube videos, in terms of different various things. So that hit me that day, and I started reading about it. I started working about it, started talking to people about it. Everybody around me was aware what I was doing. And then I started researching a lot about e-commerce website, and read that book of Alibaba. Okay, and from Jack Ma, basically I learned a lot of things from that book, that how e-commerce industry works. And so it intrigued me, it built my interest, and it keeps on building. And when I was sharing my idea with people, they were having really good thoughts about it, and it actually gave it a good finishing touch to my idea and product. It actually builds it. So it all started 2 years ago, and when I was in Zinnov actually at that point of time. And so I was the offer guy for these people, because whatever offer, sale and everything goes on, people used to come to me and ask me which phone to buy, which camera to buy, all these kind of things, because I was the one who is knowing about all the offers, wagera wagera thing. And I tried to save a lot using these offers, and tried to save my friends money using these offers. So and then it started all. I started reading about it, started building my idea, started basically made one prototype. And I decided this is something which I can pursue, and this is one thing which excites me, and this is one thing I have thought through, and now it is the time to start working on it. And and then I started working on it, and so I was very careful, and taking risk is not like you just have to jump in it. You can take a very calculated risk, start working on it, and when you feel comfortable, and then you jump. Okay, so that's what I did. And so can you hear me? Hello?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay. Yeah, so this is how my journey started. It started actually 2 years ago, but slowly and gradually, I'm at this stage right now. We are at this stage right now.
Mm-hmm. I checked your LinkedIn profile. I think you have around 50 employees right now. Would like to know, this is very fast, right? In 2 years' time, you have built a startup with a mid-sized startup, I would say, with that kind of employee strength. So how was the journey?
Okay, so basically the journey has been really great. Okay, so I would say we started with like, so it has a lot of dips and ups. Okay, as many entrepreneurs, I'm like every entrepreneur go through. Okay, so basically I started with two of my friends, but they have other commitments and that thing did not go on. Like finding a co-founder is a difficult thing. And a co-founder who is actually aligned with your idea, aligned with your vision, and who is actually willing to, you know, give their time and commitment to a particular vision of yours, what you're thinking about. And they should believe in that, because we are working on a same thing and we will be there for a longer period of time, a very long period of time, in fact. Okay, you never know. And the one thing which I learned from all the books I read about in entrepreneurship, all the videos I looked up, for all the leaders in the industry, that to never give up. Okay, so and that feeling should never come to you, but it will come to you. You should just avoid it, you know, avoid the negative thoughts of yours, avoid everything. Okay, so starting, basically I got two founders, but they left, and then I started searching for a technical partner who can, you know, build upon my idea, build upon the website or the tech, an online presence of this thing. So it took me like 2-3 months to find those guys. Okay, I finally found Shashank and Shilpa, who is our co-founders. Okay, who are technical co-founders who are working on the application and build this beautiful application for us. And so they started working on this. We started very slow. And that basically 2-3 months gave me more time to, you know, finish my idea and, make my idea or more into a plan, more into a business plan, more into a concrete thing. Okay. And so they actually loved the idea and wanted to work for this thing. And we started off. And it took us like, and we application. And so within 1 year, they have learned everything from scratch, everything. They never knew that how to make the application. So it is really commendable on their part from knowing nothing, they have created such a beautiful thing. And so I'm really proud of them. I'm really proud of the whole team which have worked with us throughout this period, since the start till now. And we'll be working, I don't know till when. What future do we have, but which looks bright actually for us. Okay, because we are not here to give up. Okay. Right. So it has been a great journey, and all about your journey, your relationship with the product. So 14th of February we thought was a good date to launch, but the product was really crappy since it was an MVP, but we got a really good response from our friends and family members, we shared it with 100 people around, and it gave us more confident and build upon the idea more and improved our application actually, and put it into a real use case, and we were able to extract value from that. And then again, good response from the media, and we were contacting some influencers as well to test out the application. Again, we received a good response on that. And then finally, we are launching our public version on 15th of August. So this has been the journey, the key point areas where our journey was, like for RevMeUp. And let's see, there will be a lot of milestone which we will have to achieve, and we will achieve that.
Right. So now whatever you have said, I have multiple questions around that. So first, I'd like to start with your co-founders. How did you find the co-founders which you have right now? You mentioned that you have gone through a phase, you found your co-founders and then they quit working on it. Then you have to find new co-founders. So how was the entire process? How did you shortlist the co-founders? How did you demonstrate your vision to them? And how did they? What was the process like? Can you tell us in detail?
Okay, sure.
I'd like to tell to our audience that I get in touch with so many founders and co-founders, and the biggest hurdle they face in their entrepreneurial journey is finding the right co-founder. They say that finding a co-founder is like finding a bride or a groom.
Understand.
For you. It's like marriage for the rest of your life.
Yeah.
So, on that note,
true. Yeah, sure. Yeah, it is actually a difficult thing to, you know, find your co-founders because having a relationship for a very long period of time, it's actually a commitment, you know, finding a co-founder and living with them for the, you know, next 5 years or 10 years of your life is a big decision for anybody to, you know, take. But the thing is ki, there is a, like, you have to, when there is a need, you have to try it out. So that journey was actually difficult, and I was really, sometimes I was worried ki, I'm not finding anybody, and I was really driven towards it ki, I have to start it. I really was thinking about, you know, learning coding myself and trying to start things. But then again, I thought ki, that is not my strength area or my core strength area. And it won't be, you know, good for me to look upon those area and try to find some partner who is actually good at it, you know, who has some experience in this thing and has ability to learn in that area of life. So I started finding out my co-founders. So basically, first I started with, starting with the initial two founders, they are my actually really good friends. Okay. It's just ki the commitment level was not there, and we were different geographies as well, and it was not that, and everybody was having their jobs, right? And one person was actually in a startup who has a great startup, so things were not working out at that time. And they made it clear in the start only, and it was really good that they came up and we cleared things out in the initial phase itself. But they kept supporting me throughout the idea, and they have supporting me since till now, right? And a lot of support I have got from them. But for example, when they left, I started searching. It took me 3 months to search it. First, I searched my network around, LinkedIn, Facebook. So I started asking my friends, visiting my friends every started calling them that what they are doing and if they are interested in this thing. But again, many people have their own commitments and have their own plans, and they find the idea interesting, but they don't find the ability maybe, or they doubt my ability or anything like that. It could be multiple factors, right? They have their own commitment, their own plans, right? Everybody, I was 2 years into this, and my network has 2 years professional into them. Okay, in my network actually. So it's just key based on their thought or mentality. They have their own plans. Many of them there have their own plans. Okay, and they are not willing to take the risk. But then again, I kept searching, and then I found Shashank. Basically, he's my actually cousin. He's my aunt's. He's my cousin basically. Okay. And so he knows coding, but he did not know application development or website. He knew website development, and we started with website development, and he was pretty convinced with the idea. He just said, ki, matlab, it's not like, it was not a sort of a commitment initially. It was like, let's start. Okay. Let's give it a shot. It was like that. And that was enough for me. I was searching for 3 months, and somebody agreed to, at least give it a shot. Mm-hmm. Okay. And so it was a big thing for me. And we started off a little, it was really slow in the start because, setting up that frame of mind, getting into that thing because I'm like, you know, he's just a new co-founder and he's not that driven as much as I am at that point of time. Slowly and gradually you drive people, slowly and gradually gets the idea whole. And then Shilpa I found from my friend's reference, and she was also, you know, into, I'm like, find the idea useful. And and she started working on the front end part. And we started meeting together every week. We try to meet together and try to discuss things. So in the starting, the things went very slowly. And we were slowly and gradually within a 3 months period of time, I would say, things were looking really good. And we had made good connections with each other. Okay. And we thought like this could be a dream team for us. Matlab, like at least I thought, I'm thinking, and it's actually proven good. It could be a dream team. And because you find the connection and right. you are very comfortable talking about things. Yeah. Right. Right. You're saying something?
No.
Just... So, okay. So yeah. So basically you get very comfortable around them, and you stop or you not stop. Basically you, counter question them, every brainstorm things, and you are never afraid of doing anything or saying anything, right? Mm-hmm. We fight, we laugh, we, you know, discuss things in a very patient manner, and we understand each other mm-hmm. in a really, good manner, and which has helped me actually and help us actually build a great product. Okay. And which will help us, you know, build a great product in future as well. So we were very good at that time, and currently the situation is that we are actually very close, and we interact every day, and we discuss about things every day. We keep motivating each other every day, and so at this stage we are really motivated for the future. Ki matlab, yeah, this could be big. This really could be big. Yeah, so that's my finding co-founder journey, and so yeah.
Right. That was a very excellent story, very nice story to hear. I think one of the founders I met, he said, if you are just one person with an idea, nobody will pay attention to you. If you are two people talking about same idea to people, they'll pay good attention to you. If there are three people talking the same thing to the audience, then it is huge. So I can relate to what you are saying.
Yeah.
So now I think that time is we are very short of time. So let's rush through the interview.
Yeah, I'm so sorry. I spoke a lot.
No problem.
Sure.
That is one very crucial aspect you highlighted here. So now my question is, when you started, how did you arrange your funds to build this venture?
Okay, so basically I must really be honest with you during the initial period of my job, okay, I was not not a saver. Okay, I spend a lot of money. I used to spend a lot of money on stupid things. And so during the first 2 years of my, you know, job life, I basically spent a lot of money on stupid things and never thought of saving. Even when my father told me to save money, I never listened. Ki matlab, like we just started doing our job, and at least I will enjoy for the first 2-3 years. So I did not have any saving per se till the end of 2 years of my job and 2.5 years of my job. And because I actually spent my money on Bitcoin shares and all, I basically, you know, burned that money into these kind of stupid investments and things like that. But when I realized ki, this is something big, rev me up basically is something which I want to pursue. And to do that, I'll be needing funds. And hence, I thought I need to start saving a lot. And I don't know how much. I just started calculating things. Ki itna to lagega, right? So this much to I will need for every month to stay, you know, afloat. And how much runway? At least you need 1 year of time or 2 years of time for yourself to, you know, settle down in a startup. Okay, settle a startup basically. And hence I started saving a lot. I cut down my expenses a lot, and So spending wisely on things, I started doing that. And so it saved me a substantial amount of money to, you know, give me confidence to, you know, pursue this thing and have a runway for at least like 1 year. Okay. But you never know ki how much money or things you have to pour in. So you have to align your finances very strongly. And I had some friends of mine who has helped me do that. And, So this is how I saved money thoda sa, like for next year, basically for 1 year of my end of my job. I saved a lot of money, not lot of money, like substantial amount of money to, you know, sustain having a runway.
Understood.
So I still have a runway of 6 months. Let's see. I don't know how long will it go. It might, you know, get finished next 2 months. You never know.
Right. So based on what you planned initially, how far have you reached and what is your vision or what is your end goal?
Okay, so based on what we have thought of, ki basically we were to become a platform where users will be. So I will tell you ki we want to become a one-stop shop solution for all the product research and buying needs. Okay, so where, since I told you ki we are we will be there in the buyer journey of a user, okay, from the start till the end of life. Okay, the end goal would be to be a place which will give a voice to the users, voice to the consumers, okay, who actually, you know, are there to buy products, okay, not to put fake things and weed out those type of companies who actually are selling bad products to users which are not worth their time, and also help users choose the best product suited for them. Okay, and the end goal, I would say ki I would like to build products suited for new age users. Okay. And the end goal is basically to this, through this platform, we've become so big ki we are able to help people, you know, to make the best buying decision like that. And so what was the question again? The end goal and how far I have reached. Yeah. So we are at the first phase of our, you know, business model, I would say, first phase of our application. And there's a lot of feature which we have thought of, you know, bringing into technologies like AR, ML, AI, ML technologies and AR technologies, computer vision technologies to make the, platform more trustworthy, genuine, and helping people out to, you know, understand technology more and more. And so at this stage we are in the first phase, and coming in the next 6 months we are planning ki we will have something which will help people a lot in making their buying decisions.
Here is my next question. Who is your role model when it comes to entrepreneurship? Okay, don't mention Elon Musk.
Yeah, actually, I just finished his, like, I read his book last month only. And I would say I'm really inspired by him as well. Okay, but yeah, there have been a lot of role model, as in ki, there are like people who you meet, and there are like people who are there, you know, who have proven things that they can do this thing and anything is possible. So my role model would be people who think anything is possible, actually. Okay. It's not like there's one role model which I follow. There are different kind of things, different perspectives you can take from every type of leader, even if they are famous or not, right? For example, if I say ki they are my friends who are like doing startups and all, right? They are my seniors who are doing startups. They were my role model when I was in college, right? And with them, I learned a lot, and they were my first role models, I could say, ki matlab, who has taught me things, how to do things, how to, you know, so basically the mindset should be all these kind of things. But then again, coming to the this part of the thing, when I started learning, you know, about Elon Musk, of course, and then Phil Knight of Nike, and these kind of personalities, when you read their stories, okay, you realize ki they have struggled through a lot, and you realize ki but struggle is actually important, because you never know things in the world what is happening, right? When you enter a dungeon, then only you know ki what are the difficulties, and you have to cross them, because you want to achieve something. You have a dream and you have to get it, and that dream gets fulfilled when you try hard, and if things are not working out, try harder and harder, right? And that's the thing, you have to hustle, okay? That's what they have taught me, what these personalities have taught me, what their life journey has taught me. And yeah, so there are different key models which we have, and there will be more. And as and when I everybody has their struggle, and everybody inspires me in some way or the other in their journey. Like, for example, a student also sometimes inspire me, who is working for working with us, okay, and interns also inspires me most of the time, that they are working so hard, they have made this solution so easy. What was the motivation behind it? What was the thing? What was the reasoning behind it? So that kind of thing also motivates me. That kind of a thing also brings up a role model. Yeah, I have to be like him. Well, it doesn't think about looking at a higher end or looking at a lower end. It's about the people around us who inspires you. It's about the people who have done this thing before inspires you. Yeah.
Got it. How do you compare entrepreneurship with a 9-to-5 job?
Okay, I'm like, there's actually no comparison. Okay, so so it's not like no comparison. So basically, it depends on the people thinking, right? I'm like, it depends on your mind, actually. So for example, during my 9-to-5, I did not like it much. And so I'd tell you I have been through the both phases. Okay, and so in entrepreneurship, what is there ki the time you do not realize ki you have spent like 8 hours or 9 hours or 15 hours or like 20 hours. You don't realize that, because there's a lot of things to do and a lot of things to discuss about, a lot of things to look forward to. You are lying awake at night thinking about the next things you want to do, thinking about the next, what is the roadmap for the next 6 months, thinking about new ideas. So that kind of things comes into your mind every minute, okay, when you are in an entrepreneur journey, right? And you do not count hours in that, whereas the stark difference is in the 9-to-5 job you count hours. Yeah, it has been like 2 hours I have been working straight. It has been like 8 hours. Like today I have spent like this much thing, and it becomes a lot of people like force rehta hai usme, right? Which I did not like, which I thought ki was a stark difference for me. And moreover, it also depends, for example, if your manager or your team or your work is motivating enough for you in a 9-to-5 job, then you don't count hours in that as well, because it takes a lot out of you, because you want to learn in that thing. It's more about learning and motivation rather than comparing a job and entrepreneurship, right? If in a job only you are able to learn a lot of things, if in a job only you are motivated enough to explore and get exposure, that is enough, I guess. And you will pick a time for yourself, or the time will pick you, that when to become an entrepreneur. And so I guess everybody finds their calling as soon as possible. But yeah, don't try to compare, try enjoying whatever you are doing, like that.
Right. So we are almost up with the time. This is my last question. It's not sure. A question, rather. What would be your final message to our audience who are potential entrepreneurs of this country? Also, anything else you wanted to share which I couldn't ask to you?
Okay. So basically, I'll start with the message. I don't know what message I could give. It's just that I would like to, I like people or the students of this country or whoever in the college or who wants to become an entrepreneur, try to explore things as much as possible, right? And like we are at a matlab like there are different kinds of entrepreneurs or different kind of things which we want to do. Okay, some people I want to be a guitarist, some people want to be a, you know, a singer, or some people want to be a drummer, okay, or different things they want to do in life. Okay, it's about your passion, finding your thing ki what you want to do, and what matlab aapka dimag kahan chalta hai sabse zyada, ya what you can't talk matlab like what can't stop speaking about. Right, that kind of a thing you need to find first of all. And once you zero in on ki ha, this is something which excites me, this is a good idea which I am having and which also aligns with my skills and which also aligns with my things. And also, like, skills are not important. The major thing is ki your ability, basically the will, the, you know, the mindset you need to have to, you know, start actually. So before starting, like I would say, ki once you have the idea, research about it, you know, ask about it from people, have different opinions, have like talk to 100 people. So no, I have actually talked to 2000 people at least, okay, since I got the idea. Okay, and you know, have been taking the inputs, have been explaining the idea to them, because I got a lot of perspective from these people only, and they improved my idea a lot. They improve my business model a lot. Okay, so talk to a lot of guys, first of all, a lot of people about your idea. Moreover, after you are confident, you know, and when you realize ki you have that risk taking ability, capability, right, then jump into it. Okay, you have to take calculated risk. It's not about like who's to finish first, and there's no competition matlab as per ki matlab you want to become an entrepreneur or not. It's just ki do it with your own pace. Okay, start with your own pace, and slowly and gradually things will find you, and slowly and gradually that idea will consume you, and you will start working for the idea, right? And so it's about the whole journey thing which is important, and it's about the whole transition thing which is important, and which you will realize once you start doing, taking baby steps, you know, at a time. Once you have the idea, research about it, talk about it, you know, make a business plan, or not business plan, just make a business plan in your notes only. Okay, it doesn't have to be a Word file or something like that, but just start taking baby steps, you know, start working towards it, and every day, and it should be every day, like 1 hour every day you should give if you have something. And yeah, so that's my advice to the people around. And never give up. That's the second thing. If you are, you know, onto something, if you think you have the hunch, if you believe in your idea, never give up. And yeah, so have that mindset, basically. I don't know. Well, like, it's my point of view. It could be, there could be a lot of people who can give you a better advice who are successful entrepreneurs. We are just starting out.
Right. It was a pleasure to have you here at ELI. I think our audience would have got lifetime lessons from this video. Thanks for your time, Aditya, and best wishes for Rev Me Up.
Thanks a lot, Priya. Thanks a lot. And you can basically go and download the application and check it out, and be available on 15th of August to watch our show. But we are actually having a show at 1 o'clock, 1 p.m. On YouTube Live. We'll share with you, share the details with you as well.
Right. Definitely. Viewers, you can follow and connect with Aditya on LinkedIn by searching for Aditya Sonkar. Also, do visit Rev Me Up website by typing revmeup.in. Also, do visit their page on 15th of August. So, whom do you want to have here at ELI for the next episodes? Do let me know in comments below. Do not forget to subscribe to our channel. We will be back before you know it. Stay tuned to Entrepreneur Lounge of India.